Hi guys, it's Christy 951. Nice to see you. Today I'm going to be doing a tutorial on how to flat iron your hair properly without burning it. Today we're going to be using my really nice flat iron. It's by Babliss Nano Titanium. These retail for approximately $250. There you go. This is a 1 1/4 inch. My hair is dry. It's just rough dried. I used a round brush to do my sweeping bang. I've got some mousse in my hair and a little bit of root boost. And I'm just gonna get right to it. So if you like, you can section the top half of your hair, the crown area, and just clip that out of your way. As I've said in the past, by doing so, you gain more control. Let's put the hair down center. Like I did in my curling video. And you just want to brush through it to make sure you don't have any snarls in it. Next, I'm going to be using my defrizzer. The Spoil Me is the Bedhead TG. I use this for curling and flat ironing and blow drying. It's a restyler. I'll be using my comb to make sure there's no snarls, like I said, and I'm just going to run it through once. I'm going to take the next section and I'll run it through once, especially the areas that you have bleach on. You don't want to burn the hair. I have my setting at 410, and this can go up to 450. Now, the good thing about having the titanium versus the ceramic, which I had for years, I just bought this one about 3 months ago, and I was like, what was I thinking? Why didn't I buy this sooner? Because I swear it can make your hair look as smooth as glass. It's beautiful without a lot of effort involved. When I don't have a lot of time and my hair is already dry because I showered the night before, I'll just flat iron it and it will be smooth and good to go within a matter of 5 minutes. Same thing on this side. So you can see I'm running my fingers through it because I like it to have body. I don't want it to be flat. I don't like flat hair. I don't mind straight hair, but I don't want flat hair. And the sections aren't real wide. Now, if you've got really curly hair, really coarse hair, you're going to definitely need to be taking smaller sections and possibly, and I do mean possibly, on a higher temperature. Those of you ladies that have finer hair, please start with it at a lower temperature and run it through more times versus trying to get it straight the very first time. I can't tell you how many times a client has sat in my chair and I'm looking at their hands going, what have you been doing? And they're like, I don't know, nothing. I'm like, you've been doing something. What are you doing every day? Oh, you know, I'm just flat ironing it. Oh, I'm like, okay, what are you doing? Holding this on the ends like this? No. Okay, you've got to pass it through the ends, not hold it on the ends, because it can get hot and burn your hair. Okay, see, that looks not too bad. I'd have to say a little bit more in the back. Right, next section. Spray the top. Just take the sections with my fingers. through it, looking for a smooth texture. This can all be done in a matter of a few minutes. Of course, it depends on the type of hair you have. Like I said, I started with my hair dry, so this is going to be going by very quickly. And those of you who think that you can make your ends not look damaged by flat ironing them more and more, think again, because you cannot. You will continue to damage them. You just need to trim them off and start from fresh. If you're wanting to grow your hair out, like many of you are, I promise you, that the technique is don't go more than 8 weeks for a minor trim, just to get those dead ends off. Get those rough edges, your hair will grow so much faster. Because once your hair splits, it will continue to split and continue to split. Let's say it's starting to look pretty smooth here. Almost ready to go. Got the girlfriends waiting to go out. Not really, but you might. Next, here I'm going to use, I often use a serum in the hair when it's wet. I mostly use it, but occasionally I'll use it dry, just a little bit. I'm talking a little bit. Just a little bit. Can you see that? And I'm actually going to rub a little bit of that off on my towel. And then I'm going to get that through the ends here. What it does is this gives you a nice, a softer appearance on the ends of your hair, especially if your hair is a little damaged, which mine isn't, but if your hair was, it'll give you a nice, non-damaged look. And if you wear this stuff in your hair prior to drying your hair, it will also help prevent damage because it seals over the hair and protects it from the heat. Okay, next I'm going to use a molding souffle. This is by Matrix. Really like this one as well. It's very light. What this is going to do is help make my hair a little more piecey. Just going to run it through. More. You know, like I said, I like my hair straight, but I don't like it flat. So next, I'm going to use my Dust-It right here. See that? It's the stuff that you use, a Schwarzkopf product. Dust it right on the roots, and you rub it in. And you split the hair right on the roots, and you rub it in. And you'll start feeling the texture. Right on the roots. Just rubbing it in everywhere, my fingertips. And it starts to travel its way down. There you go. You've got your hair nice and straight. With yet, I like to wear my hair a little more tousled versus flat. The video might not show as if it is smooth, but up close, it is definitely smooth. If you want it smoother, you can run the flat iron over it yet another time. But I like my hair this way. This is more me. So if you have any questions, please leave a comment. And if you like this video, push the like button. It'll help me out. Take care and.